interchange a block of data from source to destination. That means that you are having, you will be having two data. One data will be present in source and the other data will be present in destination. You will be having a block of data. What you have to do is you have to interchange the data. Now, let me consider that you will be having three data that is present in source. First data, let me assume it is 1, 2, 3, 4, H, and the second data, let me assume it is 5, 6, 7, 8, H, and the third data, let me assume it is 9, A, B, C, H. These three data will be present in destination. So it is 1, 2, followed by 3, 4, and 5, 6, followed by 7, 8, then last data is 9, A, B, C. This is stored in source. Let me write the number location. It is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5. I will be making a pointer, or I will be using a pointer at the source end. It is SI. I will be making use of source index pointer. Next. At the destination, you will be having three memory locations. Let me assume, let us consider three memory locations. The data in the destination is 39ABH. This is first data. And 5877H. This is second data. Let me assume the third data as 9988H. So what you have to do is, how you have to store? It is 39AB, then 5877. Next. Third data is 9988H. It is 9988H. So all this data will be present in destination. Now what I have to do is, the first data that is present in the source has to be interchanged with the first data that is present in the destination. So I can make use of source index. If you want to make use of destination index pointer, you can make use. But since the memory locations are same, I'll be making use of SI only. Then, this memory location, I can assume it to be 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Yeah, one assumption what I'll be making is the length of source and the length of destination is the same. So at that time, what I have to do is, I have to calculate the length. So length is given by dollar minus src divided by 2. Why I have to perform divide by 2? Because you are going to perform word operation. So dollar is pointing to 6 and source is starting from 0 divided by 2. This is how to calculate the length of the source. If you want to calculate the length of the destination, it is dollar will be pointing over here. So it is pointing to 16th location. 16 minus 10 divided by 2, which is equals to 3. Hence, no need to calculate the length of source and destination separately. So what we are going to assume is source data and then destination data, they both are the same. Next, what I'll be doing is, since I can't move the data directly from source to destination, if I'm moving source, destination data will be deleted, or it will be overwritten. So what I will be doing is, temporarily I will be bringing source data to AX, and I will be getting destination data to BX. After getting, what I will be doing is, the value that is present in AX I will be storing in destination, the value present in BX I will be storing into source. And then the next iteration I am going to do by incrementing the value of SI by 2. So AX I will be getting over here, then second data, that is destination second data, I am going to bring into BX register. Then I will be performing transfer operation and so on. Next, let me write the program for it. Your program starts with dot model followed by is small. So assembly directly I have written, and I have written small. Since I am going to make use of one code segment and one data segment, I have to declare it as small. Next. declare stack segment, any push or pop operations or any macro declarations if you want to do, you have to declare in stack segment next. To initialize data segment, I have to write dot data. In dot data, you have to write source, that is nothing but input as well as output as well as the length you have to declare. So let me write source. It is of defined word because I have taken it as a 16-bit data. So the first data is 1, 2, 3, 4H followed by 5, 6, 7, 8H followed by 9, 8, B, C, H. And next, length of the source is given by length db dollar minus src. If it is byte data, no need to perform divide by 2. Since it's a word data, you have to perform divide by 2. Next, destination, you have to write it as DW. What is the data assumed? It is 39ABH, 5877H, 9988H. Done? Understood with the data segment declaration? Next, you have to write code segment. In the code segment, you're going to write the program for it. So your program always starts with move AX, at the rate of data. This is initialized in the data segment and getting the data from the data segment. Move DS, AX. And next, what you're going to do is this length data, which has to be performed repeatedly, so you're going to push into CX register because your CX will be acting like a counter. So move CX, length. Understood? Next. Initial value of SI is 00. That means I have to initialize my SI register. So SI register to 00H. Done? Next. What I'm doing is, here actually my logic begins. First, the first data that is present in source, that is source of SI, I'm going to temporarily move into AX register. That's what I have to do. Next, I'll be bringing BX data with what? Destination of SI. Now data has been duplicated into AX register and BX register. Next, what you have to do is you have to perform swap operation. So for destination of SI, what you have to move is you have to move the contents of AX. You have to move the contents of AX and BX data you have to move into source of first location. Since SI is pointing to 00, you can write within bracket SI pointer. So comma BX. That's how I have successfully swapped first memory data. Next, what you have to do is you have to increment the value of SI by 2 such that you have to swap next datas. Right? Next, what you have to do is write loop a variable or a label L1. That label you can write it over here. Able to follow? So what it will do is it will decrement the value of CX and it will check whether CX is equals to 0 or not. If it is 0, it will come out of the loop. If it is not equals to 0, it will go back to the label L1 and then it executes. How many times have to execute? Another time and another time have to execute. Next. In order to terminate the program, I have to write move AH, 4CH followed by INT 21H. And to terminate the program, you can write end followed by start. That start you can write it over here. It's just an option. If you want to follow, you can follow, or you can write. If you want to write just end, you can write end in order to terminate. Next. Let us learn what will be my program output. Let us write before execution first. In before execution, when you are performing debug happens, when you are executing the instruction debug space pylint.exe, at that time you can see a memory location CD2100, that is before location, before program execution, the first data will be as it is 1234, then followed by 5678, followed by 19BC. Length, initially it will not be calculated since it is word, so you can write it as. So this is length data and this is source data. Followed by will be having destination. What is the first data? It is 39AB followed by 5877 followed by 9988. This is my destination data. This is my destination data. Right? Able to follow? Next. After executing, what I will be getting is, I will be getting the source data as this data, that is 39AB followed by 5877 followed by 9988. The length will be 0003, and destination will be overwritten with source data, that is 1234 followed by 5678 followed by 19BC. This will be my after execution. This will be my after execution. So understood with the logic, right? Next, what you are going to do is, if you want to make use of a macro, these two instructions replace with an exit macro, and these two instructions you replace with initialization macro. Next, all those macros, initialization macro and exit macro, you can declare in stacks. Right? I hope you understood with my lecture. And in the next class, we can learn few more programs. If you understood with my lecture, like the video, comment on my video, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.